Welcome back, Autistic Ladies and Gentlemen, to another Fun Friday episode in this Pokemon TCG online series. Fun Friday is all about silly and fun deck ideas, and today I bring you quite the unorthodox deck. It is a Magnezone deck, and I honestly think you won't have seen this deck anywhere before. So what is it all about? It's a deck based around Magnezone, Magnezone EX, as well as the Stage 2 Magnezone over here, and then also Raikou as a second attacker. Actually, the main attacker Magnezone is going to be our lead in the early game, and Raikou is going to be the bulk attacker in the mid and late game. This deck is actually based off of an Archie's Blastoise Caldeo deck. For those of you familiar with Archie's Blastoise and Caldeo, Blastoise allows you to power up Caldeo very quickly by attaching water energies from your hand to Caldeo as much as you want, and then you can rush in with Caldeo, hit for 50 damage plus 20 more damage for each water energy attached to Caldeo. And I ran into such a deck a couple of weeks ago, and that deck featured a Kyogre promo with a dual splash attack, which does 50 damage to two of your opponent's Pokemon. And if we look at our Magnezone EX here, Magnezone EX has the dual bullet attack. This attack does 50 damage to two of your opponent's Pokemon, so it's basically the same as Kyogre. What I tried to do is I tried to recreate the Archie's Blastoise Caldeo Kyogre deck in the standard format with Magnezone EX. Magnezone EX is going to take the place of Kyogre EX, and Magnezone, the Stage 2, is going to take the place of the Blastoise Stage 2. Unfortunately, there is no such thing as an Archie's card to Archie Magnezone onto our bench, so we will have to evolve from our Magnemite into a Magneton and then into a Magnezone. Or we can also go with the Rare Candy way, which is preferred. I do run 3 Rare Candies to evolve straight from a Magnemite into a Magnezone, and I also have Skyla to look for our Rare Candies, which should make it fairly easy for us to get out our Magnezones. Magnezone has the Magnetic Circuit ability. As often as we like during our turn, we may attach a Lightning Energy card from our hand to one of our Pokemon. This is basically the equivalent of the Blastoise of the Archie's Blastoise, the Blastoise from the Caldeo deck. So Magnezone is going to take Blastoise place, and then Raikou is going to take Caldeo's place. If you look at the Thunder Lance attack, for 3 colorless energy, we do 50 damage plus 20 more damage for each lightning energy attached to this Pokemon. Again, this is very much like the Caldeo, just like the Magnezone was like the Blastoise. Thunder Lance can hit for 110 damage if we have 3 lightning energy attached. At the same time, we reduce damage done to Raikou by 20 if we have lightning energy attached because of the Shining Body ability. Very important to note, and a very important difference with Caldeo, is the 1 retreat cost, as well as the fact that Raikou is not an EX Pokemon. So if Raikou gets knocked out, we only give up 1 prize. The strategy with this deck is going to be, as I said, to lead with Magnezone in the early game, spread some damage out with the dual bullet attack, put 50 on an EX, put 50 on another EX, and then we can come in with Raikou and hit for the knockout on those EXs with the Thunder Lance attack. Typically, we will need to have something like 3 or 4 energies attached to Raikou to get that knockout on those EXs. Most of the time, 4 energies, because then we hit for 130 plus the 50 from a dual bullet is 180, which is enough to knock out most EXs. We can also try to snap Shamans with the Magnezone EX. That's definitely a possibility. Now, I also run some other cards in this deck to help us with managing our energies. Very important for us is that we can get enough energies in our hands so that we can attach those energies with the Magnetic Circuit. One way we are going to do that is using the Clement supporter, Clement, I'm not sure how you say it, but this supporter lets us search our deck for up to 4 lightning energy cards, reveal them, put them into our hand, and shuffle our deck afterwards. So if we have Clement in a discard pile, we can VS Seeker for the Clement. I do run 4 VS Seekers, and then get 4 energy, 4 basic lightning energy into our hand, which we then can use with the Magnetic Circuit to attach to our Raikou or to attach to our Magnezone. I run 8 basic lightning energies, 8 basic lightning energies and 2 flash energies. You could run just 10 basic lightning energies, but because fighting decks are quite prevalent in the current meta, with Zygarde EX, with Garchomp, with Lucario even. I thought it was best to include at least two Flash Energies. These Flash Energies get rid of our fighting weakness, because all of our Pokemon are fighting weak. Raikou is fighting weak, Magnezone is fighting weak, and Magnezone, the stage 2, is also fighting weak. So if you are up against a fighting deck, we really need those Flash Energies to stand a chance against that fighting deck. And then let's have a look at the draw support. The draw support in this deck consists of Professor Sycamore, 3 copies, and 2 ends. Pretty standard for draw support, including also 2 Shamans. I also have 4 Ultra Balls to get out those Shamans, as well as our other Pokemon. Then I have a rather unusual Pokemon search card here, a Heavy Ball. I do run 2 Heavy Balls in this deck. Heavy Ball has the advantage over Ultra Ball that we don't have to discard cards from our hands. The disadvantage is that we can only get out Pokemon with a retreat cost of 3 or more. But if we take a look at our Pokemon, we see that Magnezone EX has a 3 retreat cost, as well as the Magnezone, the stage 2, also has a 3 retreat cost, meaning that we can very easily search out those cards with this Heavy Ball. And that is exactly why this Heavy Ball is in this list. Then I also run one Level Ball. Level Ball is going to help us to get out the Magnemite. That is basically it. It cannot be used for anything else. Well, we can use it for the Magneton as well. That one copy of Magneton, if we want to go through the entire evolution line of Magnemite, Magneton, and Magnezone. Let's have a look at the tool cards then. I run one Floatstone. Floatstone is going to be used to attach to Magnezone or the Magnezone EX because of their heavy retreat cost. And then I run the Energy Pouch. I think this is probably quite a surprise for you to see an Energy Pouch being used. I haven't seen it used in many decks before, and I actually really like this in this deck. Energy Pouch, if attached to a Pokemon and that Pokemon is knocked out, we get to put all basic energy attached to that Pokemon into our hands. So what we are going to do is we are going to attach the Energy Pouch to our Magnezone and to our Raikou. When our opponent knocks out our Pokemon, we keep our energies in our hands so that we can reattach them using the magnetic circuit to another Magnezone or another Raikou on our bench that we will have to promote into the active spot because our Pokemon got knocked out. You could run a Muscle Band or Fighting Fairy Belt instead of the Energy Pouch so that you hit for 130 with just 3 energies attached to the Raikou. But I've got to say, the Energy Pouch is probably as good or even better than those cards in this deck, because if you keep those energies in hand, it's actually not too difficult to attach 4 energies to your Raikou. And I am very glad I gave the Energy Pouch a chance, because in my original list, I kind of was tempted not to use it, just to go with the Muscle Band and a Fighting Fairy Belt. But I tell you, try it out for yourself. It is pretty useful and it's pretty clutch at times in this deck. And then for the item cards, I have 2 energy resets. Put as many energy attached to your Pokemon as you like into your hand. This is going to be used for us to get energies off of our Magnezone EX and onto our Raikou in a mid and late game, because at the start we will want to attach to Magnezone EX, but in a late game we want those energies off of our Magnezone EX and onto another Pokemon so that we can hit a little bit harder. It can also just be used to move energies around very easily. Hit for the correct numbers. If we have, for example, 2 Raikous in play, each with 3 energies attached, but our opponent promotes an EX and we need to one-hit KO that EX, we can move 3 energies from one Raikou to another Raikou so that we actually hit for 6 times 20 is 20 plus 50 is 170 damage, which should be enough for a knockout on that EX Pokemon. So 2 energy resets, then 1 escape rope for flexibility with retreating into or out of our Pokemon, in addition to the Flowstone that I discussed earlier. And then we also have some Trainer's Mail for consistency and 1 Sacred Ash to get back our Pokemon from the discard pile. I am not running Super Rod, I am just running a Sacred Ash because we already have plenty of ways to keep our energies in play using the Energy Pouch. So normally we don't really need any cards to retrieve energies from the discard pile, because the Energy Pouch will keep them in our hand and in our deck as long as my opponent doesn't use something like a Zero Seek or a Startling Megaphone. What's left now to discuss is the stadium and a couple of supporters. The stadium of choice is the Rough Seas to heal up our lightning Pokemon such as the Magnezone EX. Interesting to note is that Magnezone EX has 180 HP and that is so much better than the 170. I'm very glad they gave Magnezone EX just that 10 HP more because that can allow us to stay alive sometimes with 10 hit points. And then we have couple of one-off supporters left. We have one AZ to pick up something like the Magnezone EX out of the active spot. We can, for example, first energy reset, get the energies off of the Magnezone, then AZ up the Magnezone, promote a Raikou, and attach those energies that we picked up with the energy reset back onto the Raikou using the magnetic circuit from the Magnezone. Then we have one copy of Lysander to target our opponent Shaymin. Very easy targets for us. And also things like Hoopa, get them stuck in the active spot while we spread some damage with our dual bullet attack from the Magnezone EX. And finally, we have one copy of Fisherman. As I said earlier, I do not run Super Rod, I run Sacred Ash instead. But we still have this Fisherman to get back some energies if we really need to. We can get back 4 energies from our discard pile into our hand, and that is what makes this card so good in this deck, because we get those energies into our hand so that we can use them immediately with the magnetic circuit from the Magnezone. That is why the Fisherman is, I think, much better than the Super Rod in this deck. And that is it. That is it for this very unorthodox list. I have played a couple of times with it already, playtested it a little bit, and it has been a ton of fun for me. I think they could build this deck in many, many ways, but this is the way I went with. Leave a like if you enjoy the premise of this deck and if you enjoy the upcoming battles, because right now we are going to go and find ourselves some opponents in the versus ladder to see how this deck performs in the current meta. I'll see you there. Roko1337 is going to be our opponent with a Lightning, a Psychic and a Grass deck. This might be Night March without Shaymin. My opponent might be starting out here, and yes, we are going first. This is definitely Night March without Shaymin. We start off with a Mulligan. That was actually not too bad of a hand. If only this Magnezone was a Magnemite or something, and then we could have gotten out another Magnemite with that level ball. That would be fantastic, because we want to find our Magnemites. This is a much worse hand. This hand is much, much worse. Unless we top deck a Magnezone, then we can escape rope into the Magnezone. That would be nice. And we top deck an Ultra Ball. Alright, that's something here. That is definitely something. So I'm going to discard one energy. And probably another energy, to be honest. And I'm going to grab the Magnezone. Magnezone will help us to snipe against Night March. So we will grab this Magnezone. We will power up the Magnezone. Start powering it up. And then we are going to go for the Sycamore. I'm not going to use the Escape Rope. I will keep the Magnezone on the bench and Energy Pouch and Ultra Ball. Yes, we can Ultra Ball away. We can Ultra Ball away this Magneton. And this is a tough one. Probably the Raikou. Probably the Raikou. We are going to grab a Magnemite. That is what we are going to grab, a Magnemite for the next turn. So we can evolve into our Magnezone as soon as possible. Now let's take a look at the Strange Mail. Can we find a draw supporter? We do find a draw supporter. We find an N. Alright, that's very good. I think this is it. I might as well attach this energy pouch and then we shall end our turn here. See what Roko does, what Roko can pull off. This Magnezone is going to help us to snipe the Joltix and the Mews from my opponent if he plays them. But for sure the Joltix, unless my opponent attaches a Fighting Fury Belt. Then we'll have to snipe him twice. A Sycamore from my opponent from the Trainer's Mail. No Battle Compressors as of yet. There's another Trainer's Mail. My opponent is looking for those compressors. This Trainer's Mail fails. Wow. And a Sycamore straight away discarding. Ooh. 3 Lampons. My opponent has 3 Lampons in hand. And a Dimension Valley. So 1 Dimension Valley in a discard pile. 1 in play. Which means we can actually win the Stadium War here. We can actually win the Stadium War. Can my opponent find a DCE and a Switch? To switch out of this unknown. 3 unknowns in play. An Ultra Ball for probably another unknown. A Mew. There's a Mew. So we can snipe that Mew. Excellent. A Mew. And then my opponent is going to use the unknowns. He cannot use any more supporters. He used his Sycamore already. Can my opponent get a DCE and a switch from those unknowns? Or will we just see a pass of the turn? There's a DCE on the Mew, actually. And Hidden Power for 10 damage against our Raikou. That's okay. We are going to end here. Well, unfortunately, we have to end. That is too bad. I'm going to counter the stadium. Kind of don't want to end here. But we are forced to end. We need to find rare candies. We need to find energies. Huh. There's a rare candy. And yes, a rare candy and a heavy ball. That's amazing. That's fantastic. And we even get a VS Seeker for the next turn. So we will rare candy into the Magnezone. And I might just start powering up the Raikou in the active spot, possibly. I don't know. Maybe not. Let's not do that. Let's just stick to our Magnezone EX and end our turn. The Raikou is probably going to go down. Kiss, says my opponent. Kiss back to you. Very nice. Much kiss here. Muscle Bands on the Mew and an energy on the unknown. We will see a retreat in the Mew. No Fighting Fury Belt, which is fantastic. We will get a knockout here on this Joltik and the Mew at the same time. And my opponent cannot knock out our Magnezone as it stands because he doesn't have enough Night Marches in the discard pile. A Dimension Valley for my opponent is going to counter that stadium, counter our Rough Seas, which is okay. I don't think he's even going to knock out our Raikou. He's hitting for 80, 100. He needs one more Night Marcher in the discard pile. There it is. There is the Pumpkaboo. Pumpkaboo hits the discard pile and gets out a Lampent. Probably to discard with another Ultra Ball. Or the Sycamore. Discards an energy and a Lampent. So six Night Marches in the discard pile. That is getting very close to the amount that my opponent needs to knock out our Magnezone. That's coming pretty scary. And discards two Jolteks. So my opponent is left with just a couple of Night Marches here. That's all my opponent has left. Pretty impressive for a Night March deck without Shaman. How my opponent has been able to draw through his deck. Definitely pretty impressive. There is a knockout on our Raikou. We will promote the Magnezone. All we need to do here is find one energy. That's all we need to do. We have a Raikou. Let's bench the Raikou. Question is, do I guarantee myself the energies with... Well, I cannot guarantee myself the energies. I thought I had a Clement in a discard pile, but I do not. I do not. I must have shuffled it back in my deck. So we will attach an energy pouch to the Raikou. And then we will Sycamore our entire hand away. Can we get the energy? Please tell me that we don't miss out on an energy. Yes, we get a Flash Energy. Fantastic. And a Lysander as well. We are not going to bench that Shaman. There is no way. We will counter the stadium. We definitely will counter the stadium here. And we will attach a Flash Energy to the Magnezone. Maybe not. Let's attach the Flash Energy to the Raikou. And let's just attach a regular energy with the magnetic circuit to our Magnezone. I think that's the better play. Might as well get out another Magnezone, maybe. Maybe not. Let's wait until the next turn. For now, we'll hit for the dual bullet for a knockout on this Mew and also on the Joltik. Could knock out the Combi. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. No, I'm going to go for the Joltik. The Joltik is a bigger threat than the Combi. So we take two prizes here. We take the prize lead, but my opponent will for sure reply in the next turn by knocking out our Magnezone. All he needs is a Dimension Valley and a DCE. He only has one more Dimension Valley left. And that's something important to note. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 10, 16... I hope my whole family gets cancer. This is... wow, that is... That's just incredible. Well, what do you say to that? What do you say to that? He uses a Birch there. Kind of strange to use a Birch in a Night March deck. Can he find his Dimension Valley? We will deal with this Night March deck, most likely. I think we are looking pretty healthy, pretty decent. As long as we can keep a stream of our attackers going and a stream of energies, then we should be fine. The Vesper Queen knocks out our Magnezone as well as the Pumpkaboo. Both knock out our Magnezone. My opponent is down to 9 cards. Can he find his Dimension Valley? Discards a VS Seeker and a Combi. If he does not find the Dimension Valley, I will knock out the Combi and the Mew. We might just see a concede here. Ultra Ball for... Ultra Ball's away. a Birch and something else, and I think that's it. We will just see a pass of the turn and possibly a concede. There it is, there is the concede from Rocco 1337. So a win against Nightmarch without shaming. And win against Nightmarch without shaming. Even if my opponent had shamings, I think the game would probably be quite similar here, because my opponent drew through his deck really, really well. To be honest, he did draw through his deck really, really well. Maybe a bit too much, because he discarded those stadiums. I think that came to bite him in the ass. Hopefully his comments don't come to bite him in the ass, because you can actually get banned for saying such things on a PTCGO. And I'm actually quite surprised the chat doesn't censor that, because the chat censors Facebook and YouTube, but doesn't censor things like, I hope your whole family gets cancer. So, kind of strange. Damage dealt 100, damage dealt by the opponent 210. Magnezone EX MVP versus Mew. Let's see if we can find ourselves another opponent. Our next opponent is going to be the Noise My Name with a colorless and a water deck. We will try to go first here. We won the coin flip, we can go first. Might this be Water Toolbox? I wonder. Probably not, because Water Toolbox typically plays Hoopa. We start off with a Mulligan. So let's reshuffle our hand here, see if we can maybe find a Magnemite, the Magnemite that we are looking for. My opponent starts off with two basics, that's pretty good. That's definitely pretty good. But what are we up against? It could be Mega Gyarados as well. And there is the Magnemite. We do find a Magnemite as well as a Floatstone for the Magnemite. That's pretty nice. Unfortunately, we have to discard this Magnezone with our Sycamore. Unfortunately. Let's see. Ooh. Is it Greninja Break with Regice? That's kind of strange. That's kind of odd. I'm going to attach to the Raikou. And I'm going to Escape Rope. That is what I'm going to do. First, this Regice in the active spot. We'll attach a Floatstone to the Magnemite, and then we will Sycamore our entire hand away. Try to find some more cards. Maybe a Rare Candy. We get an Ultra Ball for Shaymin, possibly. I can do that. I can try to get a Shaymin out. Let's discard the Fisherman and a Special Energy. There is no need for Special Energies. For us, maybe I should have discarded the Rough Seas instead. But I think I'm actually going to bench the Rough Seas and bench the Raikou, then Super Rod back the Magnezone into the deck and bench the Shaymin. Try to find that Rare Candy for the next turn. Try to find the Magnezone for the next turn. We already have the Clement to get energies out. We get the Magnezone, but no rare candy. So what do we do? I'm going to discard the Magnemite and the Magnezone EX, and I'm going to get out another Shaymin. Draw some more here. We need to find that rare candy or some way to get the rare candy. Let's attach the energy pouch to the Raikou in the active spot and draw some more. I've seen more full art Shaymins than regular Shaymins today. Lol. Wow. Actually, I have two, now that I think about it. So let's end our turn. We have an excellent hand for the next turn. We have everything that we need. For the next turn, we have a Rare Candy. We have Magnezone, the stage 2, in our hands. We even have a Heavy Ball for a Magnezone EX, if we want to get it out. There's an energy on a Regice. This Regice will go down. It will go down. And a Wally into Frogadier. And then we can see a Frogadier, a Water Duplicates for the Frogadier in the next turn. So it's definitely not over. My opponent definitely has some outs here, even if we knock out the Regice. Luckily, we prevented the Water Duplicates in this turn. We get another energy. First things first, let's evolve into our Magnezone. And then let's Clement for 4 energies. Thin out our deck a little bit. We have been drawing pretty well here, pretty well indeed. We need 3 more energies on this Raikou to knock out Regice, so we will attach 3 more energies. A 1 energy, a 2, if we can, there we go, and a 3 energies, that's it. And I think I will attach these 2 energies to the Raikou on the bench. if my opponent brings out a Greninja Break, we need 7 energies, I think, 7 times 2 or 6, actually 6 energies on the Raikou in the active spot. Might just attach this to the Raikou in the active spot, just because. And we can always energy reset a lot, my opponent says, indeed. It's pretty pretty impressive what we did there, what we pulled off. Let's get out our Magnezone, just to thin out our deck. And then we will hit for the knockout with our Raikou here. Thunderlance for the knockout, take the first prize of the game, 150 damage. With our Raikou, what do we get from the prizes? A Heavy Ball. Not too shabby. Can get out another Magnezone, thin out my deck. GG, says my opponent. Oh, GG. Would have loved to play some more here against my opponent. He must not have a water energy or something in his hand. Must not have a water energy. Or is he still going to keep playing? I don't know. He would have had 2 Greninja and a break this turn. Alright then. And that's the end of that. Our escape rope saved us. The final opponent for the day is going to be Jesus Was Magic, with a colorless and a metal deck, probably a metal toolbox deck of some sort. Can we go first? We definitely want to go first. Nope. We will have to go second, unfortunately. Very unfortunate for us. Can we at least find Magnemite? And I think we can, but we might just have to sacrifice. Well, maybe not, because we have to Ultra Ball for a Shaman. Huh. Ooh, and my opponent starts off with a Shaman, so a pretty bad start for the both of us. I do have my Raikou, but this hand is not very good. This escape rope is useless. Oh no, Floatstone on Shaman and a Sycamore. So now the escape rope can be useful a little bit. This card's a Bronzong, 2 Bronzong. Wow, that was a terrible hand for my opponent as well. At least he had that Sycamore. Bronzor, Bronzor. We can snipe those Bronzors with our Magnezone as long as we can get out Magnemite in time. And that is exactly what we are going to do. We are going to snipe those Bronzors, or the Bronzongs, when they come out. An Ultra Ball is discarding an energy and an N. Ooh, 2 energies in discard pile and another Shaman. He's going to draw through his deck a little bit more. Definitely an okay start here for my opponent, despite having to discard these Bronzongs. Not too bad of a start. All he needs now is, wow, another Bronzor comes down. All he needs now is an attacker. Maybe it's just a Bronzong break deck, that's possible. Luckily we have metal resistance, we get another energy. I'm going to discard this escape rope. Maybe not. Maybe not. We can force our opponent to escape rope into a Bronzor. So I'm going to discard the VN Seeker and an energy here. And I'm going to grab a Shaman. But before I bench my Shaman, I am definitely going to escape rope. There's no doubt about it. Let's escape rope. And then we will draw into 4 more cards with our Shaman. Hopefully find a Magnemite. We need to find a Magnemite. I think my opponent will promote the Shaman though, not the Bronzor. Because the Bronzor has a 2 retreat cost. But even if he promotes the Bronzor, I have a feeling my opponent runs 2 or 3 Floatstones. One is attached to the Shaman, but I'm pretty sure he has some more in his deck somewhere, since he's running so many Bronzongs. And promotes the Bronzor, so no Shaman. In the active spot, we will Shaman for 4 more cards. Can we find the Magnemite? Yes, we found the Magnemite. Fantastic. What do we get from the Trainer's Mail? Can we get a Draw Supporter? A Rare Candy? Oh man, this is perfect. That is perfect. We can Rare Candy in the next turn. Let's grab that Rare Candy. Then let's Heavy Ball for a Magnezone. And then let's hope that our opponent doesn't end us. Because we already saw the end. We know my opponent can end us. We don't want to see an end whatsoever. Shaman for 3 more cards. I might actually just go for the dual bullets. An energy and an N. Alright, fantastic. So we have an N, we can find some more energies in the next turn. All we need is 3 energies, then we can dual bullet the Bronzors. That is going to be our strategy. Our Magnezone should be able to tank a few hits, especially thanks to the resistance. Especially thanks to the resistance. Please, no N. Please. I beg you. Just Sycamore. What is that? Another Bronzor. I mean, I think this is just Bronzong Break, to be honest. This just looks like Bronzong Break. Azy's up the Shaman. Yeah, we might actually just see a Bronzong break. We won't see a Bronzong break this turn unless we see a Wally. And that means we definitely need to evolve into Magnemite in the next turn, because Bronzong Break can snipe the bench, can very easily snipe the the Magnemite. Oh, Skyfield even discards Sycamore and grabs another Shaman. Jesus Christ, what a deck this is. This is one crazy deck that my opponent is playing, but definitely looks like a fun deck. Might just have to make this kind of deck as well. Bronzong Break is such a fun card to play. There's a Genesect, there is a main attacker for my opponent, and a Bronzong with the Metal Fortress. Alrighty. Oh, we cannot snipe the bench now because of that Bronzong. That is annoying. We cannot snipe the bench, so we will have to go with the Raikou. Magnezone is useless now because this Bronzong prevents all effects of your opponent's attacks, including damage done to your bench Pokemon. And there is the end. But no end, because my opponent went with the Sycamore. I was a little bit scared there for a moment. I forgot my opponent used the Sycamore. So we'll evolve into our Magnezone, and we are also going to counter the stadium, force my opponent to discard. Maybe not. We actually want to license out those Shamans. They are such easy targets. Such very easy targets. Do we counter the stadium? No, we shall not counter the stadium just yet. Not just yet. Let's wait a little bit. And we failed to get out another energy. Are you kidding me? We failed to get out another energy. Well, that is huge, actually. That is definitely huge. Might as well grab a Magneton and then bench this Magnemite. Cannot believe we whiffed the attack. This could swing the game in my opponent's favor. So far, we were slightly at an advantage, but now I'm not so sure anymore. Battle Compressor is going to discard some more energies. Can my opponent find his Bronzongs? Can he shuffle his Bronzongs back? That is the only thing which is keeping my opponent from attacking with this Genesect EX at the moment, or with the Bronzong Break at some point, which can come out, which can evolve from this Bronzong. My opponent's down to 21 cards, we are down to 31 cards, so my opponent is definitely drawing a little bit better than we do. Discards a Skyfield, alright. Interesting. Level Ball for a Bronzong, the last Bronzong, yes, there it is. So now we will see some Metalinks. My opponent still needs to retreat this Bronzor in the active spot though. Kinda wanna Lysander out this Genesect if I can. Lysander it out and target it. Or maybe Shaman. We have so many targets on my opponent's bench. Actually want to Lysander this Bronzong so we can snipe with the dual bullet. That's actually what I want to do. Metalinks onto the Genesect. Will we see a Max Elixir as well? My opponent has used two Max Elixir so far. Floatstone on the Bronzor. Does that mean my opponent has a Max Elixir? Maybe not. A Via Seeker for a Sycamore is going to bring himself down to 11 cards, trying to find that last Max Elixir for his Genesect. And there it is, an energy from the hand. Wait, from the hand? How did he attach that under energy? Oh, with the Max Elixir, that explains that. So now my opponent can knock out our Raikou. My opponent needs to discard some energies attached to the Genesect if he wants to do that. Two energies, I think, to knock out our Raikou. Will my opponent do that? Drive Change is going to switch the tool card out with a Muscle Band. Alright, needs to discard one less energy. I think we've lost the game here in this turn because we didn't get a knockout in a previous turn. We are looking pretty bad right now. Pretty darn bad. I'm going to promote my Magnezone. The Magnezone can tank a few hits here. Can take a couple of hits. And we will evolve into the Magneton. And then we'll also Ultra Ball for another Raikou, discard the AZ and the Skyla, find our other Raikou, there it is, and then we shall Sycamore our hand away, try to find some energies here. Can we find some energies? We have three energies in a discard pile, we should be able to find some more energies. Will it be enough to attack though? That's the question. One energy, an energy pouch. No, it's definitely not enough to attack. I'm going to Heavy Ball, look for another Magnezone. I do not have another Magnezone, so we will just pause the turn, to be honest. I'm going to Magnetic Circuits, one energy onto the Raikou on the bench here. So unlucky with finding our energies. So darn unlucky. We need to find some Listeners now to target those Shamans and get some easy prizes. And that is our only hope. I might as well attach this energy pouch to my Raikou and then bench this Magnezone. We shall end our turn here. In the next turn, I'm going to Sycamore once again. Try to find those energies. Try to find a counter stadium. Force my opponent to discard three Shamans. Ah, no, he can discard three Shamans then. Nope, no counter stadium. We are not going to use a counter stadium. Can my opponent switch this Genesect out of the active spot? Does he have any more Floatstones? There is a Metalinx onto the Genesect on the bench. We haven't seen a Bronzong break though. I'm quite amazed by that. No Bronzong break so far. Yeah, we missed out on that dual bullet early on. If only we could have gotten rid of some Bronzors. Another energy. And a drive change is going to switch out the Muscle Man for the Floatstone, if he has it in hand. Does he have it in hand? Via Seeker for an AZ is going to AZ up Shaman, I think. AZ's up the Genesect, never mind. AZ's up the Genesect. Discards that energy attached to the Genesect. And he's going to attack us for another Rapid Blaster. This should not be a knockout. We should definitely stay alive. Fighting Fury Belt on that Genesect. And the Genesect on the bench once again. Muscle Band. Will my opponent discard any energies? Rapid Blaster for 90 damage. Does not discard any energies. Is going to go for the 2-hit knockout here. Oh, we get an energy. That's good. That's definitely good. I will put it on my Raikou. Then I will Sycamore. Not going to end. My opponent only has 3 cards. And there is some more energies finally, but we don't get a Floatstone. We don't get a Floatstone. So this Magnezone will go down, unfortunately. Might as well bench another Raikou. And end my turn. This is not looking good at all. Why are we so unlucky here? Did I use my Floatstone? No, I did not. Very, very unlucky. All we need to do is deal with those Genesects. That's basically all we need to do here. Deal with the Genesects. But we can't seem to do it for some reason. Even though we are down to 14 cards, we can't seem to do it. Resistance. Actually, the stadium would have been nice there to counter my opponent's stadium. Heal up a little bit. And we haven't seen a single Listener yet either. So we'll promote this Raikou. And we will start powering it up. Fisherman. That is nice. That's definitely nice. So let's attach this pouch to the Raikou on the bench. And then let's bench maybe another Magnemite. Get it out of the way. We shall attach the energies to our Raikou. That is what we shall do. Attach those energies to our Raikou. We are going to go all in here. Use our Fisherman as well. Attach 7 energies to Raikou here. Which is short for a knockout because of the Fighting Fury Belt. That darn Fighting Fury Belt. Darn you, Fighting Fury Belt. But at least we can put some pressure on my opponent right now. As long as we don't see a Bronzong break, we have a chance. All we need to do is knock out both Genesects. Look at that, there we go. Thunderlance for a crap ton of damage. 190 damage, that is just... that is just 30 short from a knockout. We needed 2 more energies to get the 1-hit KO there. But if my opponent now switches out to Fighting Fury Belt, he actually knocks out his own Genesect. Superhot is going to Superhot back the Bronzors. Or the Bronzongs from the discard pile into his deck. And an energy as well. Interesting, interesting. Is he going to Sycamore to get those Bronzors? The Bronzongs in his hands? I wonder. Just the Metalinx with that Bronzong is going to Metalinx onto the Bronzong or onto the Genesect. We haven't seen a Bronzong break. Does that mean my opponent doesn't play Bronzong break? Maybe that's what that means. And retreats into the other Genesect. Is going to knock us out with the other Genesect. Alright then. All my opponent needs in the next turn is a Lysander to get a knockout on our Shamans. And he definitely has one more Lysander somewhere. He only used three Lysander so far. We get back all of our energies. What does my opponent get from the prizes? That's the question. Does he find the Lysander? If not, we can now put pressure on this Genesect and then dual bullet for the knockout on both Genesects. We can dual bullet for the knockout on both Genesects. Let's see, there's no need to counter the stadium. We are just going to magnetic circuit all of those energies back onto the Raikou. And knockout the Genesect here in the active spot. We are actually going to get a knockout, I forgot, because this Genesect doesn't have a fighting fury belt attached to it. So we are definitely going to knock that out. Take two prizes at the very least. We took two prizes. We just need to cross our fingers that our opponent does not have a Lysander. And I think I might just Sycamore my hand away here. Yes, I'm gonna Sycamore, try to find my own Lysander. We get a Flash Energy and a Lysander right there. And we even get a Flash, an Energy Pouch. Okay, so what do we do? What do we do? I'm going to power up my Magnezone, I think. Yes, let's power up the Magnezone. Make sure we can attack with the Magnezone in the next turn, even if my opponent gets rid of the Energy Pouch. We have a VS Seeker for a Fisherman. And there is a Rough Seas. I'm gonna grab that Rough Seas, get it in my hands, and we shall hit for the knockout right here. Definitely going to go for an N in the next turn, I think. I think I will go for an N in the next turn. What do we get from the prizes? A Magnezone and a Flash Energy. What is my opponent going to promote? That's the question. Probably the Bronzor. Yes, the Bronzor with the Floatstone, and then he's going to power up this Genesect. Hit for a knockout on our Raikou. Can he power it up and Lysander at the same time? Huh. Man, I just hope his VS Seeker is in his 9 cards in his deck. That's what I'm hoping for. Metalinks. So the Genesect is powered up. Can retreat into the Genesect. Can go for the knockout on our Raikou. Ultra Ball. Doesn't he have another Shaman or something like that? This card's a Genesect. Don't tell me he has another Shaman. No, he doesn't have another Shaman. Oh, he does have another Shaman. Are you kidding me? He can find that last VS Seeker from that Shaman. Please tell me he missed out on it. It's our only chance. We see a retreat in the Genesect. A Bronzong comes out. That's okay. I think he doesn't have the VS Seeker. I think he does not have the VS Seeker. And he has a VS Seeker. Alright, that will be a knockout then on our Shaman. GG, we actually stood a very decent chance here in this game. Unfortunately, we missed out on an early knockout. And if my opponent would have missed this knockout, I think we could have taken the game here. Because all we needed to do is dual bullet the Genesect for the knockout. And then we could have started chipping away at the Shamans with our... Magnezone. We could Lysander Shaman into the active spot, so it actually was closer than it looked. Even though we only took two prizes, I think it was much closer than it looked. Cannot believe that my opponent had that VS Seeker for the Lysander there. That last Shaman played for Shaman. What a deck that was. Definitely a nice deck for my opponent. So that's going to be it for today. That is going to be it for this episode. Leave a like if you enjoyed the Magnezone Raikou deck, this unorthodox deck that you probably will not have seen before. And subscribe to my channel for more unorthodox deck ideas. I hope you have a truly cartastic day, and I will see you next time.
Carp.